Hello guys, in this video I will talk about hash table class. So why hash table class? So what happens is hash map is not a thread safe. So when the multiple thread will act on the hash map, the data corruptions will happen, whereas in case of hash table it's a thread safe, so data corruptions will not happen. And since this is the thread safe, performance is slow, hash table performance is slow. And this hash table will contain only unique element. It may not have any null key. Okay, you cannot keep any null key in the hash table, whereas in hash map you can keep one null key, right? And you can keep multiple null value, whereas in the hash table you cannot keep any null key null value, and it is synchronized. So what I'm trying to say that is, if you look at the example number one here, we can keep null. Okay, we can keep here null, right? And we can keep multiple null value also, but in the table not allowed. So we can keep only one null key in case of hash map. So let me make this as 103, 104, 105, and here we can keep null as a value. Null. And again one more null we can keep. Okay, so we can keep that, and it will not create any issue for us in case of hash map. So if I will try to print the map, we can see that by printing it, but in case of hash table we cannot do so. Run as Java applications. So look at this. We can keep multiple null value in case of hash map, but in case of hash table, when we make the object of hash table, we cannot keep any null value. That's what I'm saying here. I'm creating the object of hash table. So when we create a object of hash table, same thing, there is no difference between hash map and hash table, only difference it is synchronized, and we cannot have any null key and null value. So we can see it here. We are putting the data, and in the similar way, the way we iterate the data in the hash map, in the similar way we can iterate over the hash table also, and the data will get printed here. So let me show you with the example. Probably I would have given this example here. Yeah, here we have a hash table. This is example one here. So here I cannot add any null key. Okay, I cannot keep null here. Now if I run that, you see what happens. You will get a null pointer exceptions, right? So in the hash table you cannot add any null key or null value, which is not allowed at all, right? So we cannot keep any null key, or we cannot keep null value also. So when I will keep here null, now let me again run that. See here, null pointer exceptions. What we will get? We will get a null pointer. So we cannot keep null key and null value. With this we are done with hash table in the Java. Actually it's almost same than the map, only the difference is the hash table is a thread safe, and we cannot keep any null key and null value to the hash table.